बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ मुजाहिद हुसैन। होप यू आर डूइंग वेल एट योर होम्स। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट फेसिंग चैलेंजेस इन आवर बिजनेस। एज यू आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट एनी बिजनेस, देन व्हिच टाइप ऑफ चैलेंजेस यू हैव टू फेस, सो वी विल लर्न एंड वी विल डिस्कस दोज चैलेंजेस इन दिस लेक्चर। सो दिस इज़ अवर कंटेंट लिस्ट इन व्हिच वी विल लर्न अबाउट फेसिंग चैलेंजेस, keeping up with the market, problem solving, money management, proper systematic way. So let's move. First of all, we are going to learn about facing challenges. Growing businesses face a range of challenges. As business grows, different problems and opportunities demand different solutions. Recognizing and overcoming the common pitfalls associated with growth is essential if your business is to continue to grow. Means when you are going to start any business, so there will be range of challenges and you have to face those challenges. If you want to grow your business, then there will be number of problems and you have to solve those problems. If you want to grow your business, if you want to go ahead in your business, and you also have to recognize the overcoming the hazards, the difficulties or the problems which are associated with your business. So you have to solve those problems and you have to face those challenges as well. And if you have started in business, then it is a very much essential that you have to grow your business. So when you will grow, then you will have to face other challenges as well. Then we have keeping up with the market. So market research is not something that you do when you start your business. Means at the time of starting of your business, you went through the market and you got the survey about the different things or any product that or any service which you were going to start. So it doesn't mean then just you have to do survey or you have to do research at the time of starting, but you have to do that survey, that practice short period of a time. Business conditions changes continuously, so market research should also be continuous to how the success of a business. What the other peoples are, what the other sellers are doing, and what the facilities are, what are the facilities they are providing their customers or consumers, then just try to do that one. If you can't do more than them, then just try to facilitate the customers according to those sellers. Then we have problem solving, that how can we go through the different problems if they are in our business goals, or they are restrictions for the growth of our business. As your business grows, you also need to be alert to new problems and priorities. So you have to face each and every type of problem. So you must have to be alert for those new problems and priorities, that what kind of problems may occur and how you have to face those problems. So you have to be alert for those problems. For example, your business might be increasingly at risk unless you take steps to ensure your intellectual property is properly protected. As you go up in your business, then their risk will be also increased. So you must have to ensure that all the property, intellectual property, and all type of protection is enabled. It means that there will be a risk, then you can handle that risk in a very easy way. If you are focusing on individual marketing campaigns, you might need to devote more resources to developing your brand. Like there is a brand which is already available in the market and you want to you want to sell that brand, then you must have, then it's not a big deal, but you have to go through that, and in that way means all the precautions, all the things and rules, regulation regarding those product or any service, just you have to follow those one and you have to provide your customers, because the peoples are habited to buy or to get those services. But if you are focusing on the new resource, new brand, your own brand, if you have developing, if you are developing new brand, then you have to devote more resources, means you have to manage number of the resources for developing your new brand. And then we have money management. Money management becomes more, even more important when cash is flowing into business and to the owner. Like if you have started business and then at the starting time there would be number of the people, they will buy on cash, or they can offer check, or they can also get anything in installment pay. So this is a very much important, that when cash is flowing in the business and to the owner, then you have to manage your money. Making the best use of your finances should be a key element in business planning and assessing new opportunities. Like you have a good balance, so that balance is a good element or a basic key element for your business planning, or if you want to enhance your business, then the finance is a key element. And after this one we have a last of this lecture, and that is proper systematic way, that how can you do this one and how can you manage this proper systematic way. Responsibilities and tasks can be delegated as your business grows, but without solid management information systems you cannot manage as effectively. Like you have a number of resources, like you have a seller, advisor or any other type of employees, then you have to divide your task and you have to manage those all things. Like you have to manage all the information. If you couldn't manage that one, then your business will be failure. You can't grow your business much. The larger your business grows, the harder it is to ensure that information is shared and different functions work together effectively. Like if your business grows, and so you must have a knowledge, or you have to be ensured that information is shared in proper way in team members, the staff which are working with you or under you, then you must have to focus and ensure that information is shared in a proper way. And what are the guys, what are the employees are working, they are working in a very effectively and very in a very proper way. So today's up to here, dear students, is there any query, is there any question, any difficulty, then comment, ask. I have also provided my email and my WhatsApp number. If you are facing any difficulty, any query, then just send me voice notes, or you can mail me, you can send me a message on WhatsApp. I will respond you as soon as possible. And stay home, stay safe, stay blessed. Allah Hafiz.